These last 3 days have been extraordinary.
The saturation of the music making.
It's some of the most thrilling arias that baritones sing, and it's all on one record.
Singing with an orchestra and doing a recording with an orchestra, you know, it's a dream because it's not so easy to do. The project itself had been brewing in my mind for a long time, presenting baritone arias, those that I have done, those that are somewhat educational in the journey a baritone takes from Baroque to modern day. The idea of doing a classical record in, you know, the country music capital of the world was appealing to me.
It was apparent to all of us that we hire American players and do this in the U.S. And we were so thrilled that Nashville came into the picture.
To know that I was surrounded by this different vibe gives it a really special feeling.
Steve's intention with this music is great. He feels it, he breathes it, he leads me, and together the orchestra and this symbiotic unity, if you will, making this great music. But it all starts with Steve, it really does.
One touch and Starbuck may survive to see.
I don't know of many albums that encompass this range of repertoire.
Do you know how many high notes this man had to sing in this stuff? I mean, all the high G's and high A flats and high A's. I mean, an unbelievable bravura tour de force of vocalism.
It's come to fruition, and it's actually happened as I thought it would happen. So that's a great feeling.
I feel like every single track has the potential to be a real hit.
It just was very uplifting for Steve and for me to be able to work in an environment where we didn't feel like we were being judged by anything other than the joy of the music making.
You know, you don't have to be a stuffy old dude to like classical music. It's open and available to everyone if you're just given a chance to hear it.